The Bronze Age collapsed at the end of the 2nd millennium BCE, changed many things in the Mediterranean. While some civilizations were forever destroyed, others suffered great damage and were forced to establish new settlements across the Great Sea. Greeks and Phoenicians quickly became the leading players of the new age of colonization. Both created numerous settlements and trading posts, coming in contact with many indigenous populations, some of which having advanced civilizations of their own. One of those civilizations was located in the southern Iberia, today's Spain, around the legendary harbor city of Tartessos. These ancient people had developed their own sophisticated culture based on trade, with their own network connecting Greeks, Phoenicians, Celts, and the old Iberian tribes. In this video, we will talk about the Tartessian civilization from the modest tribal beginnings to becoming the leading civilization of the ancient Hispania, respected by the Greeks as wealthy and prosperous land beyond the Pillars of Heracles. At the beginning of the 1st millennium BCE, the Greeks and Phoenicians started and gradually increased their colonial competition, founding a number of cities that would rival each other for centuries. In southern Iberia, they encountered an advanced and increasingly wealthy indigenous civilization of Tartessos. Tartessos was an harbor city in what is today southern Spain, at the mouth of the river Bytis, today's Guadalquivir River. It came to be an important trading center for both Greeks and Phoenicians, establishing its own sphere of influence in the southern Iberian coast. The ancient Greeks considered it an important trading center of the western Mediterranean, rich with metals, silver and gold, whose kings were highly respected among the Greek colonists and travelers. The Tartessians even developed their own writing system, likely as early as the 7th century BCE, which was based on the Phoenician and Greek alphabets. Most of the Tartessian history, including their mythological beginnings, is known from the writing which the Greek travelers, geographers, and historians recorded during their interactions with the people of Tartessos. During the Late Bronze Age, the Iberian Peninsula was home to a number of prehistoric cultures that were gradually developing. The Western Andalusian culture in the south was especially developing, having a good geographic location, ideal for sea trade with other coastal lands. The first mention of the people inhabiting these lands comes with the story of Heracles, who, while fulfilling his labors, traveled to the nearby island of Erythia, where he defeated Geryon, capturing his cattle. During this adventure, he was said to have founded a small settlement in the nearby area, and subsequently, the narrow strait separating Iberia from the coast of Africa became known as the Pillars of Heracles. People inhabiting the mentioned island and the nearby area on the mainland were the prehistoric Iberians, not much more developed than any other Paleo-Hispanic cultures of the peninsula at the time. However, the interaction these people had with other cultures across the Mediterranean through trade only increased, and these southern Iberians gradually became wealthier and more advanced than any other culture of the ancient Spain. It is unknown when exactly the city of Tartessos was founded, but given its location, it quickly became a center of an emerging civilization based on long-distance trade with Greeks and Phoenicians and their colonies. one of the first settlements established by the colonists were Porto's Menestae, founded by the Greek migrants sometimes after the Trojan War, and Gadis or Gadir, founded by the Phoenician colonists from Tyre. More Phoenician colonies were soon established, such as Carteia and Malacca. Meanwhile, the Tartessians started expanding their own culture, founding numerous cities in the area. Phoenicians quickly became the major trading partners with Tartessos, establishing network across the whole Mediterranean Sea, going from the southern Iberia to the original Phoenician cities on the coast of Levant. King Hiram of Tyre, reigning from about 980 to 950 BCE, was said to have become so wealthy from the trade with Tartessos that from the minor clan city of neighboring Sidon, Tyre became the richest and most prosperous city in all of the Phoenicia. The first known Tartessian ruler was said to be Gargoris, the king of Kinetes in the western Tartessian region. According to the story, Gargoris had a child with his own mother, something that was unacceptable and forbidden by the Tartessian customs. Out of shame of committing incest and also fear for his own future, Gargoris had the child exiled and abandoned. However, this ultimately did not save the king Gargoris, as the child, named Habis, grew up and returned to the kingdom, surprisingly receiving widespread support. He was recognized as the new king and had all the Tartessian lands unified under his banner. Subsequently, the Tartessian trade network was enlarged and additionally increased by the Hellenic-Phoenician competition in the Western Mediterranean, where Tartessos was doing business with both sides. Large amounts of iron and other metals were secured from the neighboring tribes, including Celts, who had migrated to Spain from the north. The trade was then conducted with the Phoenicians and their colonies, but also with the incoming Greek colonists, which had started founding their settlements in the northwestern Mediterranean coast. Around 8th and 7th centuries BCE, the Tartessians have developed their own writing system based on the Phoenician alphabet. At first, they apparently attempted using the alphabet of the Phoenicians to record their language, but soon switching over and developing their own script, with numerous stelae and graffiti inscriptions being found throughout southern Spain and Portugal. Tartessians traditionally had good relationship with Phocians, the Ionian Greeks from Asia Minor, renowned for long sea voyages. According to the Greek historians, the Tartessian king of the late 7th and early to mid 6th century BCE, Argentonius, invited the Phocian colonists to settle in an area nearby Tartessos. The Phocians, however, politely declined the offer, instead founding the city of Massilia in 600 BCE and Emporion in 575 BCE. Shortly afterwards, the Phocian colonies became the main trading partners of Tartessos, while the rivalry with the Phoenicians intensified. Another proof of the Tartessian-Phocian friendship came after Phocia, the original homeland in the Asia Minor, was endangered by the emerging Median Empire in Anatolia. King Argentonius provided large sums of money to the Phocian mother city in order to build walls and fortifications. Phocia would ultimately fall not to the Medes, but to the Persians in 546 BCE, and many of the Phocians, refusing to submit, decided to leave overseas and settle in their colonies across western Mediterranean. Phocians from Massilia would end up settling nearby Tartessian territories, founding a city of Mainaki on the southern Iberian coast. The Greco-Tartessian trade network would continue to prosper until the rise of Carthage, the most powerful colony founded by the Phoenicians. Carthage was founded in the 9th century BCE as a colony of Tyre. It gained independence in the 7th century BCE and gradually expanded, founding colonies of its own on the Iberian coast and across the western Mediterranean. The renewed Greek expansion into Iberia alarmed the Carthaginians, and an open conflict was inevitable. Another important factor were the Etruscans of Italy, the allies of Carthage, who grew increasingly worried about the Phocian Greek expansion in their neighborhood. The Greco-Tartessian trade was heavily disrupted, and the Tartessian regional dominance of the southern Iberia was on the swift decline. Tartessos was losing its wealth and with that its power, losing the inland territories to Celtic and Iberian tribes, while being stripped of its coastal influence and trade routes by the Carthaginians and their newfound colonies. Series of inconclusive wars were fought between Carthage and its allies on one side and the Greek colonies on the other for the control of the western Mediterranean trade. Ultimately, the result was Carthage becoming a great power in the region, gaining dominance over the much of the Iberian Peninsula and the surrounding islands and territories. With that, the Tartessian civilization was no longer sustainable, with most of its territory being overrun by their neighbors and its once wealthy and powerful capital fading into obscurity. The Tartessian descendants, called the Turdetani, would eventually rise up and gain prominence, becoming an important regional factor well into the Roman times, but that is something that we will discuss in one of the next episodes. Please consider subscribing and sharing this video, as it greatly helps the visibility of the channel. Your support is greatly appreciated. This was WanaxTV, and we'll see you again soon.